Hi there, Agilos is here, and today I'd like to share with you one of my games. I had the white pieces, I played the move c4, and my opponent, Crazy Is My Life, is approximately 1700 elo player. He played this move g6, okay, knight to c3, bishop g7, and as Lichess mentioned, this is English opening, great snake variation, but in any case, I can see that they had fantasy names for every move, every possible move. Now e3, I used to play many different setups here, but I choose this one. The idea is to control solidly the d4 square. We have e6, d4, d6, and again, playing like that is not very recommendable. It's like hippopotamus, something like that. Maybe white would like to develop the other bishop here, but it's not very recommendable because you are staying back, you are giving a lot of space to white. And I decided to attack immediately, to do something about this fianchetto, and one idea to attack is to play h4 and h5. I learned from Fischer. Fischer used to do it very easily, and he used to say, if you like to attack in this fianchetto, you should throw your pawn forward. And now he didn't do anything, he played a6, and of course I played h5. Knight to c6, bishop e2, try to increase the pressure here. Now he developed the knight. This is a normal move. I was waiting for that, and now I just played h6. And this fianchetto bishop has a problem now, because he should retreat in his initial square. So I developed my knight, knight to e7, e4, another normal move. He gave me the center, so I'll take it. Bishop to d7, and I just continue developing my pieces. Bishop g5, everything is normal, right? Knight g4, moving the same piece twice, it's not very good. I just exchange here, queen takes e7, and the good news is that he solved the problem from this problematic dark square bishop, but he has problems in dark squares now, because his bishop, it might missing in the future. Continue the development, and now my next move could be something like knight to g5, in order to kick this knight away, and then to castling short. I cannot do it immediately, because if I castle here, then this pawn on f2 will drop. And suddenly, my opponent dropped his piece back. Thank you very much about that, because I don't need to move my knight now, I don't need to care about that. And his elo, I say again, it's approximately 1700. What is the best player that you ever managed to beat? You are very welcome to post it below in comments. So I castled long, and now he played another move, knight to a7, and I don't really understand this. Probably he was afraid to castling short. If I was black, I'll do that, or I play something like e5 in order to keep the position close. But he played this very strange move, and in general you should find a plan behind your moves. And you can see that I didn't do anything specifically. I just capture the center, develop my pieces, and castling. Nothing very special. Now I played e5 because he gave me this opportunity, and when the opponent king is still in the center, you should open lines and attack there. So e5. Knight to g8. Now he has another poor piece, and this knight is the poor piece, and not only the knight, but the rook as well is very bad placed here, because these pieces cannot move thanks to this powerful pawn. One pawn equals two pieces, right? My pawn is restricting these pieces. And after that, I have the opportunity to play d5, and I'm trying to open everything. He captured here, now I calculate a little bit, because now things are not very easy, and when you have a space, you need to calculate correctly. And if I capture immediately on e5, then he might capture here on d5, right? What are you going to do now? And I calculate about that, and I capture there, and I was expecting to recapture here, but this helped my initial plan. I have two ideas here. One of them is to capture first of all the bishop. He should recapture with queen or king, I don't know, and then I can recapture on d5, right? On d5 here. And another idea is, after e takes d5, this is what I was expecting. I was planning to play bishop to f3, because now my knight is taboo, it's untouchable thanks to the pin on e-line. I can play this move, and now white is winning thanks to the pin. And I protected my knight tactically, then I'm threatening to capture here, so black may face some problems here. But he didn't capture any e5, and he just castling. He thought that we can exchange some pieces and just to castling long side. And now I played queen e3 because I'd like to protect the knight. This is the obvious idea, but there is a hidden idea behind it. He just played that one, and after my next move, he resigned. What did I play? Queen takes a7, and now I'm threatening a lot of things. One of them is checkmate on a8. And he played a little poorly, to be honest. And you have a system, you have an idea how to play against this g6 move. One critical line is here when we open the game with e5. And the next move, the critical next move, is when we play d5. You should calculate about that. And definitely at one point on your game, you should calculate correctly what to do. So thank you very much for your attention, for your watching, and see you soon.